this morning, the kiddos are going to stay up here with us in our service, since it is a Christmas service, and since it's we got a video to watch and even a video with some of the kiddos on it, so we're looking forward to that. But Merry Christmas to everyone. You guys know how I feel about the Christmas holiday, but we're almost there. You know, I love the meaning of Christmas. I love why we do Christmas, but for those of you Scrooges like me, we're almost there. But this morning we celebrate Christmas as a church family. With this being the Sunday before Christmas, we remember the Nativity. With this being the Sunday before Christmas, we stop and we remember Jesus being born. Obviously, we should remember that, you know, throughout the whole season. We should remember that throughout the whole year. But this is the Sunday that we really stop and we remember Jesus. This Christmas season, we have been going through a sermon series that has taken us through the classic movies of the Christmas season. We started off with It's a Wonderful Life, and then we went to Christmas Vacation, and then last week we looked at The Grinch. This week we're going to look at a less popular film as far as like critical acclaim and through Hollywood, but a film that's probably more important than the other ones. And this movie is called The Nativity Story. This is the story of the birth of Jesus. All other Christmas movies, you could say, exist because of this movie. If Jesus was never born, if there was no nativity, there would be no Christmas, and therefore, you know, there would be no Christmas miracle and It's a Wonderful Life. There would be no, you know, good old-fashioned family Christmas if it wasn't for Jesus being born. The Grinch wouldn't need to steal Christmas if there was no such thing as Christmas. So really, this movie is the precursor to all other Christmas movies. So even though this film, in and of itself, is not, you know, one of the classic movies that we think of, didn't set any box office records, it is by far the most important Christmas movie of all time. But this movie covers the events that are described for us in the Gospels of both Luke and Matthew that we read through and we come to every Christmas season. And although the biblical accuracy of this movie isn't perfect, it's close enough for our purposes. You know, the facts of what happened when Jesus was born, they're all in the Bible, and we've read all of these 100 times. You know, every Christmas we read these stories, and we hear, you know, the reading of Luke 2. But the facts of all those sometimes get just a little bit confused. Sometimes they get a little muddled in our memories. Sometimes we have most of the details there, but not every single detail. And sometimes we don't remember it quite right. Watch this video here.
Hi, I'm going to talk about when Jesus was born.
Angels sing glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild. God and sinners reconciled.
Joyful. Oh, you can take your mask off.
I can't remember any of it. And, how Jesus was born?
Uh-huh.
I forgot it. Mary and Joseph were pregnant.
Eon.
Mary and Joseph had Jesus.
So, first, an angel came to Mary's house and told her she was going to have a baby. And Joseph was his dad.
And his mom and dad was Jesus and Mary.
And his parents were Mary and Joseph.
Bethlehem. The bed with hay and stuff in it, and then in a farm. I forgot again. He was born in a barn, and there was animals there. Animals. He was born in a hospital.
They rode on a donkey,
and they couldn't find a hotel.
They found a barn.
There was no room for the baby. Mary ate him in a manger.
Jesus was born in a manger. They came to a stable. He was born in a old barn. Jesus was born in a manger.
The baby was named Jesus.
So the shepherds came.
People that were the king.
Wise men came, and the first people he thought God told were shepherds.
Sheep and some camels.
The wise men.
And how the three wise men found him was an angel.
And that the wise men came and gave the baby a present.
And they brought him gold and myrrh and frankincense.
One of the wise men gave gold. One of the wise men gave a bracelet. And the other gave a bundle of hay.
I told you I don't know.
Frankincense, gold, and myrrh.
Like silver and gold.
For God so loved the world, he gave his one and only Son. For whoever believes in him will not perish but have eternal life.
Jesus was born on Christmas Day.
And I'll have a rainbow.
There you go. So kids, you guys did a great job. Go give them a hand. Right. 99% right. That's awesome. We won't talk about the 1%. That was just great. Jesus was born in a hospital, and they went to a bar because they couldn't find a hotel. That is like the millennial version, I guess. I don't know, but that was awesome. And like I said, for the most part, you guys were there. But the story of Jesus being born is central to everything that we believe. It is central to everything that we put our lives on. If Jesus would have never come from heaven to earth, none of this would matter. Because if it wasn't for the birth, there would be no death, and there would be no resurrection, and there would be no redemption for our sins. Jesus came down. Jesus came down as a baby, not as a ruling, as a conquering king. He came as a helpless baby, born in the first century in a barn, put into a feeding trough, the lowest of low, the humblest beginnings for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Watch this clip from the Nativity story.
How's your faith now? Rejoice. I bring you good tidings of great joy, for unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. you will find a child wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger.
He is for all mankind. We are each given a gift.
The greatest of kings, born in the most humble of places. God, made into flesh.
Gift of myrrh to honor thy sacrifice.
Thank you.
Jesus was born. God here in the flesh, here on earth. And from the beginning, he was worshipped. And from the beginning, he was given gifts. Now, obviously, this clip isn't exactly how the Bible has it. You know, the wise men didn't visit Jesus on the night he was born. More than likely, he was around 2 years old, and they came to see him in a house. But what I love about this clip is it captures who Jesus came for. It captures who Jesus came for. You have the shepherds. You have the overnight shepherds. This was the third watch shepherds. These would have been the lowest on the totem pole in the shepherding community. And shepherds weren't people that were into much prestige anyway. There wasn't much prestige in shepherding. So these guys that came and saw Jesus on this night were pretty low in the social order. This is what Luke 2 says. It says, in the same region there were shepherds out in the fields keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with a great fear. And the angel said to them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God, saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased. So we see the angels come down from heaven, and they go and they find the lowest of the low. The people who are on the bottom of the food chain there in Bethlehem, and that's the people they seek out. That's the people that they find and they tell about Jesus. That's the people that they go and give this good news of great joy for all people, the lowest of the low. And they get up and go and worship the King of Kings. And then on the other side of this, we see the wise men coming from the east, the Magi coming. They're there later because they've got further to travel, but they came nonetheless. From the Gospel of Matthew 2, it says, and he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, that I too may come and worship. After listening to the king, they went on their way, and behold, the star that they had seen went and rose before them until it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then opening their treasures, they offered him gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. So here we see these great men coming a long, long way to get to where Jesus is, to get to where this baby is. And they come into the house and they fall down and they worship him. And they give these very, very costly gifts to this family. Not bracelets or bundles of hay. I don't know where that came from. But they bring gold and frankincense and myrrh and give this to this family. So here we see this beautiful picture of this baby Jesus and Mary and Joseph. And we see these shepherds, the lowest of the low, come and they bow down before him. And then we see a couple years later, we see the greatest of the great, these wise men come and they give these costly gifts and they come. But both of these, the lowest of the low and the highest of the high, coming and worshiping Jesus. We have the low and the poor and the shepherds, and we have the rich and the elite and the wise men. The lowest of the low and the highest of the high. Ones that slept in the fields at night and ones that slept in the palaces in the Orient. Ones that talked with sheep and ones that conversed with kings. Yet here we see both of these groups coming and kneeling before the king. We see these interactions between the shepherds and Jesus and the wise men. We see both of these groups. We see them bow down before him. The rich and the poor and the lonely, they are all thankful and awestruck by this baby. Because Jesus was a gift for all people. Jesus was a gift from God to all mankind. And this all-inclusiveness that was there in the first century is still here today. There's no one that has ever been born, or no one that will ever be born, that is not covered by this gift. To the poor and to the rich, to the connected, to the lonely, to the broken, to the lost, to those who have their lives together, and to those whose lives are a complete mess, to the white, to the black, to the man, to the woman, to any and all. To those who are caught up and wrapped up in sin, to those who are reeling in this life, to those that are in the deep, dark places that this life, that this broken world can give, Jesus came for us all. Came for us all and came for us for all time. When Jesus was coming to save humanity, he was coming to set up eternity. He was coming to save every person who had ever lived and would live forever with him. He was the gift for those in the first century, and he was the gift for those in the 21st century. When the angel came to tell Mary that she was going to have a baby and that that baby would be the Son of God, the angel was very clear and made this truth known to her, that this baby was going to sit on God's throne forever and ever. This is from Luke 1. It says, "And the angel said to her, 'Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great. He will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end.' And Mary said to the angel, 'How will this be, since I'm a virgin?' And the angel said to her, 'The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the God Most High will overshadow you, and the child will be born, and he will be called the Son of God.'" So we see right out of the gate the angel telling Mary, this is going to be the Savior for the world, and he is going to reign forever and ever and ever. Jesus was coming to set up eternity and to give that gift to all mankind, making a way for all mankind to be reunited with the Father. This was the grace of God being manifested through a baby, the love of God being made full in the flesh of this baby coming down. Because God loved humanity so much, all of humanity, God loved all of humanity so much, from the lowly shepherds to the exalted wise men to the kings, he loved them all, that he was going to send Jesus for all people. That is why Christmas is so important. That is why we spend a whole month every year talking about Jesus being born, because this gift from God was coming down to earth. From Luke 2, it says, "And Joseph went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David that's called Bethlehem, because he was the house and the lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were staying there, there came time for her to give birth, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, laid him in a manger, because there was no place at the inn." God in the flesh arrived. God in the flesh here on earth. That verse that we just read literally contains the greatest Christmas present ever given. A gift of salvation, a gift of peace, a gift of hope, a gift of joy, a gift of love. God with us. God Almighty, the creator of heaven and earth, here in our midst. God made human, coming down to this earth so that he could live among mankind for the sole purpose. For the sole purpose of living a perfect life and going to the sinner's cross. For the sole purpose of going to the cross so that he could take the nails and take that crown of thorns so he could die. For the sole purpose that he could be buried and then on the third day rise over death victorious. There is no greater gift than that. There is no greater source of joy than that. There is no greater show of love than God sending his son for all people. This gift was for each and every person that has ever existed. Just like in the clip that we watched from the Nativity story, from the highest of high to the lowest of low, God loved us all. That's why John 3:16 is the most famous verse in the whole Bible. I'm so thankful that Asher put that in there because it shows us how much God loves us. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. It says God so loved the world. The world, every person who lives in the world, every single person from every single race and ethnicity, socioeconomic group from each continent, culture, and community, God loved them so much. Each and every individual who has ever lived, God loves that person so much that he would willingly give up himself and send his son so that he could die, so that these people, so that the world could have a way back to him. God loved the world so much that he would go to any length to get us back. That he was going to do everything that he can to get us back to him and so that we could be redeemed, so that we could be together. From John 4, it says that we have seen and testified that the Father has sent his Son to be the Savior of the world. That whoever confesses that Jesus is the Son of God, God abides in him and he in God. The greatest gift of all time. Jesus, Savior of the world, and a Savior for all people. And a Shepherd for all people. And a source of love and joy and hope for all people. Jesus, the Son of God, the Savior of the world, the greatest gift ever given. So in this week leading up to Christmas, in these next 5 days, I want to challenge you to remember Jesus. And I know that sounds crazy because we should always remember Jesus and we should always be thinking about Jesus, and that should always be something that has, you know, should be in the forefront of our thoughts and our conscience. But in this week, remember Jesus. And I know it's going to be difficult because I know there's so much stuff to do. You know, most guys haven't even started shopping yet. But there's, you know, there's shopping to do, and there's wrapping to do, and cleaning and cooking and all of this stuff. And we get caught up in that chaos. But I challenge you to remember Jesus this week. Remember the blood that saved us all. Remember the Savior that came down. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much that you sent Jesus. We are so thankful that you sent this gift to us. We are so thankful that even though we didn't deserve it, even though we deserve your punishment, and we deserve the shame from our sin, God, we're thankful that you sent Jesus. We're thankful that you sent Jesus to come and live a perfect life and to come and die on a cross for our sins. We are so thankful for that gift. We're thankful for your love and we're thankful for your grace. We love you and we are yours. And it's in your Son's name we pray. Amen.
Father, we thank you so much that we had the opportunity to come in your house this morning. Let us remember the gift of your grace and the gift of your love. We love you, we are yours, and it's in your Son's name we pray. Amen. Merry Christmas.